What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of Blazers Pulse. Now, I didn't realize how long it had been since I had done one of these videos. It's been over a year. The last one I did was before the bubble last season. If you don't know what Blazers Pulse is, it's a poll-based video. I post polls in the community tab and then I go over the results. That way, I can get a bit of the pulse of the fan base, so to say. So a couple days ago, I asked you guys 6 poll questions. We had a pretty good turnout for most of them, so I'm looking forward to going over some of the results and giving my answers to some of the poll questions. Now, leave a like on this video. It really does help us out, and subscribe if you're new. We're only 50 subs away from 5,000, which will be a huge milestone for us to hit. And make sure you stay tuned with the upcoming videos we're going to drop. We're going to drop more videos in the next 7 or 8 days than we've ever done. We're going to get you geared up and ready to go for the offseason. We're going to have coverage every step along the way. One final thing, if you want to follow me on Twitter, at TorreyJonesYT is the Twitter handle. Without further ado, let's jump into the poll questions. Now, the first question I asked was, if you had to do one of these trades, which one would you do? This poll had 195 votes, which is far fewer than any of the other polls, so I don't know what happened with this one, but didn't get as much traction. I have 5 trade packages at the bottom. Now, 57% of you chose CJ McCollum and 2 first round picks for Pascal Siakam over other trades such as CJ and 2 firsts for Ben Simmons. So that shows me that at least the people that watch my channel, they would rather have Pascal Siakam than Ben Simmons. Now, the poll results and the answers to a lot of these questions depends on where they're asked. If this was Pinwheel Empire on Twitter, rest in peace, by the way. If this was Pinwheel Empire on Twitter, then they would probably get a lot different results for this one and definitely for an upcoming question. The other 4 trades were pretty even. I try to make them as even as possible, but a lot of you guys are like me and want Pascal Siakam. That was also my answer to this question. I would choose CJ and 2 firsts for Pascal over any of these other trades. Poll question number 2, I asked you, how badly do you want to trade CJ McCollum for a forward? 5% of you said not at all. 5% of you are not on the trade CJ bandwagon. I mean, I'm not fully on the bandwagon. I'm kind of halfway hanging at it right now. But there's 5% of you who aren't even on the thing, and it's about to tip over because there's so many people on it at this point. Even the people that weren't trade CJ before this previous season are now stepping onto the bandwagon. 53% of you said you're cool with trading him for a better player. 53% of you said you're okay with trading him for a forward that's better than CJ. Only 33% of you said you're okay with trading him for a similar caliber forward, which was a little bit surprising to me. I figured a similar caliber player as a forward would be like a Tobias Harris. So just reading into these answers, it seems like 58% of you would not do that trade because I wouldn't say Tobias Harris is a noticeably better player than a CJ McCollum. And 58% of you said you're only trading him for a better player. You're not trading him at all. So I thought that was extremely interesting. 3% of you are okay shipping him off for a lesser player, maybe a TJ Warren. And 6% of you said trade him for anyone. That should be 0%. I'm a little bit disappointed in 6% of the people that answered this poll question because I'm not trading CJ for Kevin Love. I'm not trading CJ for John Wall. So the fact that you'd trade him for anyone is just a little bit ridiculous to me. If you voted to trade him for anyone, please let me know down in the comment section below. Let's see if anybody who chose that option is bold and courageous enough to step up. Poll question number 3, I asked, what's the most you'd offer Norman Powell a year in free agency this offseason, assuming the deal would be 4 years in length? And I'm a little bit disappointed in some people in this poll because there's 8% of you guys that wouldn't pay him more than $16 million. I mean, Norman Powell is worth more than $16 million, and the fact that some of you wouldn't even go over that amount no matter what is absolutely crazy to me. Let me know if you're one of those people down in the comment section below, and let me know exactly why, because it doesn't make any sense to me. 31% of you said you wouldn't pay him more than $19 million. I think it's likely that it gets $20 million per year at least. So there's 39% of you that would just let him walk if that's the case, if he gets a $20 million a year offer from somewhere else. That's much too high of a number, to be quite honest with you guys. 47% of you said $22.5 million. 9% of you said you'd be willing to go up to $26 million, and 4% of you said you'd be willing to go up to $30 million or more. I chose 26 million. I am in the 9% that chose 26 million. I would maybe even consider 27, 28 if that's what it took to keep him. We don't gain anything by letting Norman Powell walk in free agency other than a $9.5 million mid-level exception compared to a $6 million mid-level exception. That's not a noticeable difference. That's all we get by letting Norman Powell walk. I would rather keep him even if you have to overpay. The salary cap will go up in future years. That deal wouldn't look as bad unless he declines, and I don't think he's going to decline over the next 4 years, so I think he's worth that contract, and it allows you to trade CJ if you're able to bring him back, so you can't really lose him. So that's why I'd be willing to go up to 26 million. The fact that there's 39% of you that wouldn't go above 19 million and 8% of you that wouldn't go above 16 million is just it's head scratching to me. Poll question number 4. I asked, do you want Carmelo Anthony and or Enes Kanter to return on minimum contracts? And I put a slash on the end. Obviously, that's a typo I didn't catch in this graphic until now. But regardless of that, 13% of you want them both back. 36% of you want to bring back Melo only. 14% of you want to bring back Kanter only. And 36% of you don't want to bring either of them back. So it looks like it's about a 50-50 split between whether or not people want to bring back Melo on a minimum contract. It looks like only 27-28% want to bring back Kanter on a minimum contract. So people are favoring Melo over Kanter. I chose don't bring either of them back. I want defensive players in those backup roles. I mean, maybe I'd take Enes Kanter as a third string big, but I would rather take a flyer on like a Harry Giles as a third string big if he can't get a better deal elsewhere and wants to come back. I would rather do that than bring back Enes Kanter. So I want defense off the bench. Last year was a defensive nightmare in terms of our bench. I don't want that next season. And I know a big part of it was playing Melo and Kanter together, but I don't want either of them. I would love to have two good defensive front court players to bring off the bench. Poll question number 5. I asked you guys, how worried are you about the Damian Lillard trade rumors? Quote unquote. And I was a little bit surprised by the answers to this poll because I thought a lot more of you were going to be extremely worried. It seems like there's a lot of people on Twitter, a lot of people across the internet that are extremely worried about the Damian Lillard situation. But 46% of you said you aren't even worried at all and he'll definitely be back. 41% of you said slightly worried. You think he'll be back, but you're not entirely sure. That's the camp that I'm in. I'm probably in between the first two options. He's coming back. I think he's coming back. I can't say it 100%. I can't say it with total certainty, but I think he's coming back. I would be shocked if he doesn't. Even he thinks he's coming back. He said he expected to be in a Blazer uniform next year. Maybe that quote from Dame helped sway some of these answers to the left side of this graphic. That is 87% of you that are not worried or only slightly worried. There's 8% of you that are worried. You don't know if he'll be back next year. 3% of you are very worried. You think he's going to request a trade, but you're not sure. And 2% of you are extremely worried, and he's definitely going to request a trade this summer in your eyes. So I'm liking this. I thought it would be a lot more even. I kind of wanted to at least make one of these polls even, and that wasn't really the case, as you can see. But yeah, I think all the trade rumors and trade speculation about Damian Lillard is just a waste of time, and I'm not really worried about any of that right now, and it seems like neither are you guys. And for the final poll question, I said I was only going to ask 5 poll questions, but then I was like, wait, I completely forgot to ask what their feelings were on Neil Olshey, because I was definitely curious to see the answers here. Now, this sort of question, the results are extremely dependent on the audience it's asked to. If this was asked on Blazers Edge, you would probably have like 95% of the people saying he's the worst GM to ever walk the face of the earth. And half of those 95% would be asking for an option that says he's the worst GM to ever exist in the entire universe. So I ask it here where me and Eric, we're not anti-Olshey. I wouldn't say we're pro-Olshey either. I can't really talk for Eric specifically, but me at least, I'm not pro-Olshey. I'm not anti-Olshey. I'm kind of in the middle. So my answer to this was he's been solid, made some mistakes, but some good moves too. I thought he had a good offseason last year, so that definitely plays a factor here. Even though I didn't like the Derrick Jones Jr. signing at the time, I still think he was solid last offseason. So I think he's been a solid GM. 36% of you agree with with me. 6% of you think even better. You think he's done a good job and gets way too much hate. Of course, I think he gets too much hate too, but I wouldn't necessarily say he's done a good job. I think he's done a solid job. There's a difference there, I guess. Maybe I should have differentiated them more. I don't know. But 42% of you think he's at least been solid. The overwhelming choice was he's average, but you guys don't think he can get us over the hump. I was kind of leaning towards that answer because I don't know if he can get us over the hump either. I think he needs to be creative this offseason. He needs to show a certain level of creativity that we've never really seen from him. But I was a bit surprised to see 90% of you think he's been average or better as a GM. 8% of you think he's been bad and want to fire him now. 3% of you said he's the worst GM to ever walk the face of the earth. And I think that's a little bit hyperbole. Obviously, there's a small percentage of people that answered this poll question that never heard or paid any attention to Billy King in Brooklyn. So with that, that's a wrap for this episode of Blazers Pulse. Hopefully you enjoyed. Feel free to post your answers down in the comment section below, especially if you didn't participate in any of these polls. If you had a really bold answer that not a lot of people agreed with you, say you were in the 2%, 3%, or 4% of an answer, then stand up and let me know down in the comment section below why you thought differently than most of the other people that answered the poll questions. You might get me agreeing with you or saying you're making a good argument. We definitely promote believing in your opinion and standing strong with them, even if a lot of other people disagree. Obviously, that's kind of been the thing with me and Eric over here on this channel. So that's a wrap for this video. Hope you enjoyed. I'll see you next time. Until then, as always, peace out. Go Blazers.